Hello there, you're in time for Urban Today. Thank you for being part of us this beautiful morning. My name is Lynn Komdish, of course, with Henry Second Jaco. Good morning to you.
Morning, Lynn. How are you doing?
You look very sharp.
It's a Thursday.
Who are you trying to bribe?
No one. Mm. You want to, you know, like those guys of Mukamanayamba.
I thought you were not going to mention that.
Mbambi, poor guy. What would you even take, you know, 3 million shillings back from Mukamanayamba?
No, listen, Henry, first of all, do you know what Mukamanayamba is?
What I know is an energy drink. I've never tested it because I'm not a person of energy drinks and all that.
But I know you and your health diet.
Exactly, yeah. But it was a bad one.
So what happened is that Ubos people, some bosses, In the Western region, the regional manager. Actually, I think we have his name. He's called Vitalis Shaka. He told these guys, we are not going to issue a certificate unless you give us 4 million.
You can imagine.
There were two guys. The other guy's name I didn't note. But then they allegedly over hygiene issues. So they were netted on their way out.
After getting the 3 million shillings.
It was 4, actually. Mm. 4. I think it's 4 million.
Okay.
But why? Of all things, Mukamanayamba. You can't even fear the title or the name. As in, literally, can't you just be afraid of the name?
That was really bad.
That was terrible.
That shows you what happens, you know, in these institutions. Mm-hmm. People go on asking for bribes here and there. It's okay, something that is...
Don't worry, Mukamanayamba.
This was a bad one, though.
I have a friend who says everything Mukamanayamba.
Oh, dear.
Anyway, away from that, Henry, also some... do you remember the sex party?
The Shireka sex party? What's happening?
The suspects have been charged.
Oh, finally.
11 of them have pleaded guilty. Okay, wait. So they've pleaded guilty to what?
Holding a sex party.
I thought... Okay, never mind. My mind is wasted.
I knew where you headed.
Some of them have pleaded guilty, and 22 were arrested for in all 22 were arrested for holding a sex party that was over the weekend, and they have been some 13 have been, you know, charged with sex offenses. So those are some of the stories. But you can join the conversation on social media at Urban TV Uganda, that is Twitter, at Seka Henry on Twitter, as well as at LineG3 on Twitter, and Facebook at Urban Television Uganda, that is Urban Television, Lynn Komjisha and Seka Henry, that is all on Facebook. But you can also go to our New Vision Digital Experience app. Okay, some technicalities here and there, but yeah, it is an app. It is an app that is the future. It is futuristic. So go there, you'll have everything at your fingertips as you just scroll through. Now, Henry, today is Thursday, the 15th. Two things are happening. Schools are reopening, and there's a nomination for members of parliament.
Wow. What is happening?
It's quite a lot today. It's quite a huge day. So talking of schools reopening, we realize that many of the schools might actually not open today as expected because they do not meet certain requirements.
Like we've been saying before, that most of these schools don't meet the SOPs. And yeah, the report is out and most of these schools don't meet that.
That's true. That's true. And parents are, we've been talking about this. Parents are taking the brunt of everything. Remember, some parents are being asked by schools to make sure they pay first-term school fees.
Up to zero balance.
This is terrible.
Very bad.
Very, very bad. So parents, I don't know how prepared, like I've been asking you this whole week, how prepared are you? And if you're not, then what are you doing about it? And how do you move forward? We'd actually want to hear from parents and of course students to know how exactly prepared or not they are. Yes, so some 22,500 of schools have so far been inspected in northern Uganda, Northeastern and Eastern districts all have been covered. This is according to the Ministry of Education as they continue with the inspection of schools.
Of course, and they're saying that about 7,425 schools squared between 50 and 59.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, they've been given, these don't meet the requirements.
They don't.
And of course, they've been given an extra 1 week to put the things in place so that they can also be allowed to open.
Yeah, so some 14,800 have been cleared to open, and today, my God, I don't know, there's going to be traffic, Joe?
There's going to be traffic. The fares are likely to go up.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know, you've been taking you for 5,000.
That's right.
Public transport is likely to, you know, to increase because this guy is a big deal for them.
Public
transport sector.
It's expected. Mm. It's expected. It happens all the time when schools are reopening. But I would imagine it is worse now because we have a global pandemic to deal with, you know. So schools also, you know, have their own demands because we realize most schools actually need money. Most of them need money to start operations.
Yeah.
And so they're saying... the parents definitely are the ones who are going to, you know, feel the pinch because they need one. First time school fees, if you haven't cleared, if you had not cleared.
By the uniforms, you're talking about uniforms.
Yes,
last time,
because yes.
Some girls have now grown on size.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, parents have to foot bills for new uniforms.
That's true.
Books. So.
All this that
would be very hard for parents.
They need, they need food. They need a lot of things to for the operation of the day to day activities. So parents, prepare yourselves, please, mentally especially.
And of course, we're talking about schools not being ready. You know, maybe the reason why some of these schools have not opened up. There was one of you know the leaders, private schools in the Choli sub region. She came out to say that schools there have not been able to meet these SOPs
mm-hmm.
because they've been paying out money, you know, half salary to their teachers,
ah.
staff members. Yeah, so you know they run out of money, and they've been able to, you know,
and
acquire some of these things, the sanitizers and,
yes.
and the rest of your requirements.
And they're not the only ones. You know, that would be an example of what might be happening elsewhere. So parents, today you're going out there, we wish you the very best. Students, as you go back to school, please take good care of yourselves. But parents, I need to know that your mental health is well taken care of. Banange, parents, prepare mentally. These things are supposed to happen. These things will happen anyway. I know you're frustrated. Some of them are frustrated, Henry.
Yeah.
But they need to, you know, have a positive outlook.
They should be worried because the Minister of Education has come out to say that schools that have not been given certificates for opening,
yes.
they shouldn't be opening.
Oh.
So parents, I think they are scared. Where am I going to take my kid?
You know, and you know, the ministry said that schools that do not meet the requirements have their students taken to other schools. So that is also a
but
challenge.
But itself is, you know, a hassle because just imagine, you know, taking your kid from this school where they've been,
mm-hmm.
that means you have to pay new fees.
Of course.
You know, recruitment fees, registration fees. Because
some schools require you to do an interview.
Uh-huh. And all that is paid
And that is all that's paid
it's
for.
A hassle. Mm.
So parents, please, I would love to speak to you, please. Your mental health is very important at this point. So just be positive about the outcomes of everything. I don't know. Please be positive about it. Just don't kill yourselves over what's happening or not happening. Now, away from the reopening of schools, today is also nomination day for members of parliament.
Sure.
And
tomorrow.
Yeah, today and tomorrow, of course. Remember, they were moved from the 12th to 13th, from the 12th and 13th to today and tomorrow, 15th which
and
is 15.
16th.
Yes, yes. So the nominations are taking place today at all election commission offices countrywide. So we urge you to be very, very cautious.
Mm-hmm.
I mean,
and observe, you know, the guidelines. And
yes,
the that
observe the existing
by,
guidelines.
Yeah. By the Electoral Commission and the Ministry of Health.
And most importantly, avoid processions.
Yeah, and the police has come out to warn.
Mm-hmm.
If you're found to be in a procession, of course you'll be punished.
Punished is an understatement. I have a feeling police is like on set go.
Mm-hmm. If they see in a procession,
they'll
come for you.
Hey, if they see, you'll be in trouble. So, well, the Electoral Commission has issued tough guidelines, of course, away from police guidelines, but the Electoral Commission has also issued guidelines and said there will be washing of hands at the Electoral Commission nomination centers. Two people only. Two people. So if Henry is going for nomination, it's only me and Jimmy who can access.
Exactly.
We're only us.
And they're talking about the proposer and the seconder.
Yes. So one has to be a proposer, the other is a seconder.
Yeah.
So only allowed
taking the entire clan.
Yes.
Company.
There's no need. So you also are required to have only two cars if you're moving. That is only two cars, and those two cars must have not more than three people.
Sure. Yes. Including the driver, surprisingly.
Of course, not more than three people, including the driver. Then you acquire a sticker from the police for vehicles to access the nomination venue.
Meaning if you don't have a sticker, you're not allowed to access the venue.
Simple. So if you haven't done that, I don't know what you're up to. Then, now the new spokesperson, Joel Senyon, said, well, it is good to have these guidelines, but then they have a tendency of applying these guidelines selectively.
That's true.
Is that true?
Yeah, I think sometimes it has happened. We have seen instances where, you see an interim, candidate being cleared to go, and then,
an opposition.
Yeah. I think it's something that happens that police should avoid, so that they don't have come out to accuse you of, being partisan.
That's true. So I think we need to be very careful. Just go with all the requirements, including the 3 million shillings.
Sure.
You must have a receipt. So if you get there, be as orderly as you would want your election to be. Don't just go making noise for.
Yeah, and Linda, of course, as nomination is gone today,
yes,
there's a tendency, a growing tendency in the country, especially in the city,
mm-hmm,
where people are defacing their, opponents' posters.
What?
Yeah. When you move around Kampala, you find posters are being defaced, others are being pulled down.
But of why?
Course, I don't know. They want, maybe they don't want to. Be,
anyway, I think it's a behavior that has been going on. I remember even in 2016 elections, the same thing happened. People would deface, would deform, would create their own faces over people's posters.
And I think that's a bad thing because, just allow the competition.
It is really
decide who they want to vote.
It's absurd.
And by the way, it attracts an offense of 1 year in prison.
Uh-huh. So if you're caught defacing or building or creating or making your own face on someone's face already, then you're in trouble.
Mm-hmm.
Big time trouble. So stay away from trouble. Well, Henry also related this. I don't want to call this relatedly, but somehow people are putting the things together. They're saying there's a connection somewhere, and I don't want to think like that.
But somehow, what connection are they talking about?
People are just corrupting my head. Security raided Noop offices.
Oh, yeah. And the city center.
And the city center, yes. Downtown, along Loom Street. So yesterday, security raided Noop offices, some places in town, and guess what? They were looking for people dealing in military attire. Yes, stop saying it was politically motivated. No, no.
Apparently, if you move, on the streets of Kampala, even some political parties, of course, police is, picking out Noom. People have, have made it a habit to, imitate police attire.
Police and military.
And military attire. And I think this is a very bad thing because these things are gazetted.
Yes.
They're supposed to be used. They're supposed to be used by certain security agencies.
So for you, you just want to flaunt them, scare people, intimidate us. They have caught you. I think so. So security raided Noop offices and seized some prohibited gear. They also conducted an operation in the city targeting individuals that deal in or wear attire that look like that of the military. Berets. Other items like batons, items like, military attire, the trousers and what.
Yeah.
So some of these
they're
things,
not using the same color as military, but of course the imitation.
The
looks
imitation.
Like, looks like that of the police and the military.
But then what happens to, this is out of Uganda. I've seen Kanye West and his family wear those things. They're an imitation, not exactly the same. It's like a fashion trend of sorts. So if it is fashion...
Maybe in their country it's not... Okay, I'm sure they are gazetted, but...
Yes, they are gazetted,
maybe they
but...
don't have a law that prohibits citizens from wearing those particular attires. But in Uganda,
they're
of course,
not
it's
particular,
prohibited.
Particular. They're an imitation.
Yeah, it may not be the particular one, but of course, if you put that on, you can confuse someone down there.
That's true.
That's true. So I think maybe that's why police is coming out to say that you guys stop it.
And I actually want to know, you know, there are shops downtown where you meet those imitations of camouflage, yeah?
Yeah?
They like to call it camouflage. So it is an imitation. It's not, even the material is quite different. So yeah. I don't know, did they confiscate that as well?
Yeah, they confiscate them, I think.
What?
I bought a shirt, you know, it's army-like, right? Mm-hmm. It's a very beautiful shirt, but when the police came out or the army came out to say that to ban the public from wearing such, you know, attires, I stopped. Yeah, but it's a very beautiful shirt that I bought,
loved,
very expensive.
I've always loved camouflage, but then
this looks so beautiful.
because of that, I usually stay away from it. So maybe I should become a military officer. Just
yeah,
to
and you
feed
wear it
my...
officially.
Yeah, and wear it officially. So, yes. Now, the spokesperson of the UPDF, that is Biekwaso, Madame Biekwaso, she tweeted that, so if you have anything in your possession that has a likeness to military attire or police attire, voluntarily surrender this.
Mm-hmm.
So
give
if you surrender, you're okay, you're good to go.
Because if you're found wearing it, it would be an offense.
Yes, you'll be caught. I mean, you'll be arrested.
People can start wearing those things in their houses, as long as you're not going to move out. You can put it on in your house.
But Henry, I have a question.
Mm.
Why now?
That's also suspect, by the way.
Mm-hmm. Why now?
But isn't the first time they're coming out?
Yeah, it's
I remember... Either this year or last year, they came out to warn the public.
I think sometime
they came out to warn the public. When NUP had just introduced those berets.
The berets.
So they came out at, you know, to warn the public that you guys...
But even NRM people had their own berets. Did you see that?
Yeah.
Were they also confiscated?
There was a concern that only red ones were picked up.
No, I saw yellow somewhere in one of the photos, but I didn't really see the logo on the yellow berets. So surely... I hope they were not selective.
Yeah,
as
so.
They have been accused of.
So
okay.
Of course, these the NUPU guys are complaining that during the riot, of course, most of their very sensitive or important documents, including the signatures, were picked. Apparently, they're planning to take these signatures to the Electoral Commission for the nomination of their, you know, presidential flag bearer, Robert Kyagulanyi, on Friday.
So
they are concerned. Where did we start from? And then I'm like, didn't I have a backup somewhere?
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm not laughing that it happened. No, I'm laughing that is the accusation. Like, that is the best thing they can come up with.
You never know, because quite a lot of things were picked in that scuffle.
Did you see any?
And I was seeing on TV, and they used those grinders to open the offices that were closed.
I wonder, in all this, where was Bobi Wine?
Apparently, we're told that he was at the part offices, you know, addressing the youth when these guys raided their offices.
So they did not touch him?
That I didn't see him anywhere during the scuffle.
Did they touch him? Okay, fine, of course they didn't see him. Maybe he was... I have a feeling there's a bunker in his building.
You know?
Anyway, so those are some of the things that happened yesterday. But NUP alleging that they... Well, I don't know. I don't know what they confiscated.
Plus some 23 million shillings.
Even that was taken.
So not only signatures.
What? We need more details on this.
All right.
23 million.
Mm-hmm. That's what I hear.
And then
there's
signatures.
There's a tweet I saw that was making rounds on social media that they took their signatures and then some 23 million shillings.
Okay, I'm hoping you guys had a copy of the signatures, because if you did not, then that's really...
Yes, it's really trouble.
That's
because
really
nominations,
sad.
Nominations are coming up on the 2nd and 3rd of
that's
November.
That's really sad,
so,
if you
know,
didn't have a copy.
I'm sure they kept a copy somewhere.
I mean...
They just can't, you know, leave
they should,
such
they
important, you know, stuff in the open like that.
Okay. Well, so this is what happened yesterday. Now, also, away from that, we are still, you know, continuing with the investigations over the cyber attack on telecoms and banks, over where some 10 billion shillings was, you know, taken away. The latest is that five more suspects have been arrested, and it turns out that these hackers got the 2,000 SIM cards sometime in June.
That's true.
They secured them, and they, according to the investigations, these SIM cards belong to certain companies. Most of them belong to certain companies. So
the telecoms?
Yes. No, the SIM cards are registered under certain companies.
Oh.
Yes. So if they got one of the SIM cards, maybe belongs to a certain company, is registered under a certain company. So that is how they managed to do that. So they, the hackers cashed out money at 2,000 mobile money withdraw points. So which I am thinking, maybe there were some 2,000 hackers. Okay, well, maybe.
That's quite a big number.
That's quite a number.
Maybe they were using one person to do about, maybe let me say 100 transactions.
Okay. That makes sense. That makes sense. Well, and this whole thing was done in 36 hours.
Wow.
Eh. People have upped their games.
These guys have speed, yeah?
People have upped their games. Goodness.
That's their profession. That's what they do for a living. So
but the good thing is that you police...
I can only imagine they have all the skills that they need.
But how can you pull off such... Did you watch Money Heist?
I watched it halfway.
You must have
a clear, concrete plan.
Plans. A and B and Z. Anyway... So the police says it has also identified locations used to withdraw the cash. Banks and telecoms discovered the breach on October 3rd. We still don't know when it actually happened.
Maybe
the actual date.
But it was this year.
Yes, of course it was this year. And it was not, it was in between June and now. October 3rd, yes.
Oh. So... But of course, investigations are on, and we hope these telecoms corporations
have
been asked to, and we get a concrete report on this.
Absolutely. Some seven suspects have been arrested so far, and the investigators are quite happy that one of them is productive, and he has first-hand knowledge on how the offense was orchestrated. And my goodness. Well, so there it is. They have one suspect, at least, who has some details over what happened, how it all started.
So he's giving them some good leads.
I hope he's not misleading them. Look, I watched too many movies.
Those guys are very skilled, so they know how to get information.
This is what I'm saying.
Like you have said, you're only paying that he tells them the right information.
They're saying he has all the information, but what if it is a plan by the hackers for one of them to tell them the right information while misleading them? Yes, I've watched many movies. You can't blame me. I have to think outside the box. Okay, guys. All right. So those are some of the stories, you know, still making headlines. And of course, be reminded, today's nomination day for members of parliament, as well as schools reopening. And we'll keep you updated on any new developments in that regard. Okay, we'll take a look at today's court.
Of course, today's court says that hard work betrays none.
As simple as that. Hachiman Hichigaya. This guy sounds like he's from Zimbabwe or something.
He's an African. He must be an African.
Yeah. Hard work betrays none.
Meaning if you work hard, you get gains here and there.
I mean, guys, if you don't work hard.
Yeah, if you don't work hard.
Just four words. Self-explanatory. Work hard. And you won't be betrayed by anybody.
But anybody, yeah.
Okay, that's it. So we'll take a break right now and get into what's happening in today's dailies. Welcome back. You're still watching Urban Today. Now go to our social media pages. That is Urban TV Uganda. Join the conversations. That is on Twitter at Urban TV Uganda. At Lynn UG3, at Seka Henry. And that is on Twitter, Facebook, Lynn Komjisha, Seka Henry. But most importantly, Urban Television will be there. And you'll be part of our conversations. You could also download the New Vision Digital Experience app. Yes. And you'll have everything as you want. Wanted. Today's headline reads, many schools to remain closed. Too bad, too bad. 2021 elections, presidential nominations to be in Chambogo. Yes, we discussed that yesterday. The Election Commission issues tough nomination guidelines. That is for members of parliament. 73 to compete for city member of parliament positions. No processions in Kampala or anywhere in the country. So move. Have your mask on, wash your hands, sanitize, and make sure you just come. But you don't have to be rowdy. You can always do anything without the rowdiness. Now, sex party, suspects plead guilty. I still want...
This was, you know, very clear.
So I'm guilty
so
of
if
what?
They denied, seriously.
I'm guilty of
it would
what?
Be very bad.
Henry, how would you say you're guilty?
You're guilty of what?
Mobile money theft.
Don't say it.
I'm not going to say it. Mm-hmm. I can't afford to say it. Mm. Okay, so we get into the papers and see UNBS managers arrested over Mukama Nayamba drink bribe. Never yeah. That is already Mukama Nayamba there. So focus on empowerment programs, not family planning, says Katikiro. Eh? Mm-hmm. IGG acquires specialized software to investigate electronic fraud. UPDF Widows Group receives assistance. We have personal level English language. We also have biology, so get yourself a copy. It's only 2,000 Uganda shillings. Now also, remember, we are still celebrating 58 years of independence. We are looking at a lot of things, education, ICT, and local government. Check it out. In Business Vision, which is Thursday's pullout, will 30 billion shillings bailout work for tourism companies? That's a good one. Mm-hmm. That's a good one. Then elsewhere, Biden-Trump duo in battleground states. And also, of course, in sport, money costs you. Before sports, this is Dr. Love writing. Money costs you a right to negotiate.
Wow.
Okay. Then in sport, there's friendly rivalry in Poland. Who is who, Cheptegei and Kiplimo? Get yourself a copy.
All right. Nebukadde fulumyedda agenda mu katalo bengo maguli ya kunusu lukumi lokaloka. Bakulemeza omuntu okugamba nti lwaki police ezinze wa Bobby. Amagye ne police boogedde ku bikwekweto bye bakoze mu kibuga lwaki babikoze gula katabu kakabukedde obenga obisoma ebisingawo era tulaba nti lwaki police bazinze ku kitebe kya NUP babikoleredde wano eno abagenda okwewandiisa ku baka balabuddwa bekibi balabudde gula katabu kakabukedde obenga osoma ebisingawo era tulaba nti yali minisita w'Emmengo ne mutabani we bazze kuvuganya ku byobufuzi Minister Chino ne mutabani we kigula katabo kakavu kidobenga osoma ebisingawo FDC simbyewo abantu ku kasibante neza ke bantu kibe simbyewo binabena biri mu katabo kakavu kedde abamulufula abawadde nsonga ezibagobeseza abakulembeze nsonga ki gula katabo ku akavu kedde obenga osoma ebisingawo poze nkalu ku fees nga masomero gagulwawo binabena bikwesedde mu katabo kakavu kedde bona ku lwali bakwesedde byokusoma byekibiina ekyomusanvu n'ekyomukag Natera mbio mzini tulaba ntino Ronaldo bazanyi bane batide okubasiga corona lwaki batide of course tebagala kufuna corona yo gula kataka kabu kidobenga osome bisinga pozi yana bafufa basatira lwaki basatira bena bena biri mukataka kabu kidona ko leo nusu lukumi lokaloka keguli obenga osome bisinga
all right they are on the newsstands as we speak and they're not very expensive 2000 for New Vision 1000 for Bukede as well as subscribing to our e-papers you get access to these papers also the Daily Monitor is out government relaxes rules as schools reopen so get yourself a copy and titles to get new features CJ that is the CIF sorry My bad. Hmm. The Chief Justice. Eh, I was so off. Chief Justice warns politicians on rigging, then 3 million SIM cards off network. These are some of the stories the Daily Monitor is also looking at. Be clear on your love expectations from the word go. Don't just go there for, okay? SC Villa is now yours.
Oh, who's taking it?
Who is this? You'll find out if you get yourself a copy of the Daily Monitor. Now, away from that, tomorrow is World 16th of October. Food Day.
That's true.
Yes, it is celebrated every 16th of October. Mm. And now, people in Kampala, some 17%
yeah, that's true.
Of Kampala residents face food insecurity.
That's true.
So we're going to sit today in a bit and look at World Food Day, what the theme is for Uganda, what the theme is for the world, and what we need to look at. Why are we food insecure? What happened? We are the food basket of East Africa.
Of course.
What happened?
And of course, looking at COVID, we need food.
Absolutely.
And not just food, but important food.
Absolutely. Mm. So there we're going to discuss that in a bit. But thank you for being part of Urban Today. Join the conversations on social media. Be part of the conversations. Join us and let us know, you know, what your thoughts, your questions are, what you are doing right now and what you plan to do much later. Maybe just be part of this conversation. It is you and I and, of course, Henry Sekanjoko. We'll take a break. We'll be right back.